Right, so I have just done my makeup. It is show day. It is around 7 o'clock, I think. So far I have woken up, checked in with Cuba. 1 minute. I do have a phone, but I do not know where the phone is. Oh, here it is. I will show you my check-in like I did yesterday. I haven't actually looked at them. So you're seeing them at the same time as me. So this is me this morning. I'm happy. So I've just, like I just said, just done my makeup. I've had my breakfast, which was one bagel, one egg, 80 grams of steak, 5 grams of butter. I have had a coffee. I'm gonna have another coffee. Obviously they're a natural diuretic and it helps you go to the toilet as well. Sorry if that's too much information. And then I'm just gonna chill out, do my hair a little bit, and then get ready to go to the venue for 9 o'clock when I'm gonna have my base coat of tan. I'm gonna have 50 grams of salmon, 50 grams of rice, 2 rice cakes and 1 Rice Krispie Squares bar. Feeling all right, making sure that I'm still drinking so that I don't go black. But yeah, feeling quite good. So I'm just here waiting for my tan. We've got a little bit of a queue at the moment just because they had a couple of tanning machines that broke. So I thought I'd run over some of the questions that I've got on Instagram again. So the question that I'm going to go over is, do you ever lose belief in yourself or compare your body to other girls? No. Because I guess if you lose belief, you lose motivation, and there are days when I don't feel 100% yes, but my motivation and my commitment and dedication to what I want to do is still there. So I don't think that I ever lose belief in myself. I also have a very strong unit of support people around me who believe in me also. And then in terms of comparing myself to others, I can't, because I don't look like anyone else. Like, nobody looks like anyone else. You can't compare yourself to anyone else who's in your class, anyone else who's around the world, because you don't ever look like anyone else. You will never grow to look the same as anybody, so there's no point in comparing yourself. All you can do is focus on working hard and being consistent and making sure that you give 110%, and that way you will bring your best, and that's all that you can do. So another question is, can you speak about training intensity and how do you know that you're doing it? So training intensity, I don't think it's something that you can really explain on a piece of paper or explain on a message. A lot of my clients have come to see me for a session now where I take them through a session, or they come and train alongside me, where I will put them through a session where they're pushing themselves to the limit and train to true intensity. And I think that that's really the only way that someone can be learned or taught, is by actually witnessing it with someone else doing that, or by someone pushing them to that. And that way I think that that's how you learn to do it, and that's how you will see how it is done. So I couldn't urge enough going and training with somebody or going training around somebody who you know does train with true intensity, because as good as it looks on a video, the energy from a session when someone actually trains with true intensity is mad, and it's motivating in itself. So I've just had my tan done. I quite like it actually. It's a bit of like a reddy brown, and it's kind of my natural colour, so I'm really happy with it. Gonna chill out now, just waiting for Cooper to finish his tan, waiting for Rhea to come back from over there. I don't know what she's doing, and then we're gonna go and chill out. Oh, I've just found the key. I was wondering where my car key was, but it's there. But yeah, so we're gonna go and chill out now. It sounds like the event's just started, which means that they're actually running half an hour behind so far, but it's fine. Gonna go and chill out, enjoy the day, feel a lot less stressed now that I've got the tan on, so hopefully today will just run nice and smoothly now. Rhea still does tan, just to let you know. It's very good to still put some tan on to make yourself look nice and shimmery on stage, even when you are. Of rice, 18 grams of salmon, 50 grams of salmon, and 4 of these little dark chocolate orange rice cake things. Cooper's just helping Neil Curry and Shane Cullen pump up, because they're doing their pro debuts in the classic physique class. And then there'll be a little bit of a break in classes, and then it will be me the next on stage. So Phoebe's just going to do my hair now, because I'm really rubbish at being a girl. So she's going to straighten it and make it look super nice.
Francisca. 131, Megan Sylvester. 132, Frida Hester. 133, Jane Tingle. And 190, Samantha Jiri.
Respect!
Ladies, quarter turn to your right.
Uniform, mate, hold it.
Quarter turn to your right.
Yes, mate. Sit back into it, mate.
Quarter turn to your right.
Nos vamos a ir a comer, ¿sí? Luego venimos. Que hacía la entrega de premios luego a la tarde.
Face front.
Vale, falta bolsita, por favor.
Yes.
Ah, mira eso, en el juego de Cuba.
Thank you, ladies, you can file off stage. Thank you, judges. Thank you, Bill. Thank you, ladies. As our ladies set up backstage for the individual pieces. Okay, Megan Sylvester.
What it was. Saw the pills on the table for your unrequited love. I would be nothing without you holding me up. Now I'm strong enough for both of us. Both of us.
Representing Denmark, Frida Hester. One, 119, Rael. 121, Maria. 123, Marta. 127, Hannah. 131, Megan. 133, Jane. 132, Frida. 121, Maria. 127, Hannah. Switch places. 132, Frida. 131, Megan. Switch places. 119, Rael. 123, Marta. Switch places.
Japanese front. One, 2-7, Hannah. 1-2-1, Maria, switch back. Ladies, face the back curtain. Face front. Thank you, ladies. You can file off stage.
Thank you.
And wine.
Thank you.
She'll
go on
that.
It's good, yeah. Came second call outs in my first pro show. And I actually came third call outs in my bikini show, so second call outs in my first figure show is quite impressive. So I'm super buzzing. Just got a lot of size to put on for next year, but we can do that, no problem.
Not many athletes can go from bikini to figure in what, 18 months? And come second call out in a pro show that's 20 deep. You've got Olympians in here, you've got people that have gone to the Arnolds, you know, and Megan's there, bam, second call out. You should be so proud of yourself.
So proud of yourself.
Don't make me cry.
I feel emotional.
Slippy
or anything like that, and it's quite nice to move around.
Yeah, it's quite nice. Open pole figure champion 2022. Rhea Gann.
It's almost like Cupid.
Congratulations, well done.
We are back from the NPC European, just got back home, feeling tired, but feeling full of motivation from the weekend. So obviously this was my first figure pro show. I actually did a bikini pro show back in 2018 when I actually won my pro card at the actual competition that we've just been to 2 years ago, where I came ninth in the bikini open. But the standard at the competition that I went to, not just in the pro kind of division, but also in the amateur ranks, the standard of the competition that we've just gone to, honestly, it blew my mind. I was watching, I think it was the women's figure and the women's wellness, and every single girl in the top six of both of the class, of all the classes, kind of ranging from the shorter ones to the taller ones, all could have been pro standard, in my opinion. So the show was stacked, but it was really nice to go and see that, because I think that you can then go away from the competition and realise how much you actually do need to work. When you're in a gym at home and you're around the same people and you see the same people each day, I think that I don't become complacent, because I work hard and I literally couldn't work any harder than what I do. But it just kind of makes you realise how much work you need to do to be kind of world standard and to stand out across the crowd of people that kind of compete around the world. But I was really, really happy with what me and Cooper brought to the stage in terms of my physique for the figure class. I've never actually been that lean before that I was, but I still need to be leaner, and that's what we will do for Romania. I was really happy with kind of my package, like I say, but I wasn't happy with my presentation, and I think that Kuba can agree with that as well, that my presentation, I literally pose after every training session. I've done that in off season, I've done that in prep, I do that in the morning, I do my rounds before I actually do my pictures, and then I got on stage and I froze. I don't know if it was the crowd or the fact that these girls were absolutely incredible. Like, I was amongst people that have placed at the Arnolds, that have placed at the Olympia, that have placed at places like the universe, and I did very well, but I think that the nerves did get the better of me. So I won't let that happen in Romania. That will not happen. I will bring a better package, I will bring better presentation. Obviously 1-2 years then I'll be competitive, but I will bring my absolute best to the next competition. With everything, I've got some posing lessons booked in, so everything is kind of on a roll already to be better. So yeah, I will be documenting obviously my prep leading up to the Romania show. Also going to go and support Cooper at the British finals. They don't actually have my class there, unfortunately, but hopefully next year they will.
British Grand Prix.
British Grand Prix, sorry. What did I say?
British finals.
British Grand Prix. See, they don't have my class, so they need to do that so that I know what it's called. But hopefully next year they will do, so that I can compete on home soil. It would be really nice to do that. Looking forward to the next 5 weeks leading up to Romania. So stay tuned to watch what happens.